Hey guys, having a good day?
Okay?
Yeah.
Hallelujah! The people, you know!
nation here is big enough. This nation is the best. With golden soil and wealth for toil, for we are one and free. We stand together all as one, blessed by the Aussie dream.
Campaign by our government to terrorise and instil fear in the people. As mothers, we all know that your children are sick if they've got a fever, if they've got a cough, if they've got a runny nose. You keep them home from school. There is no such thing. It's one of the biggest lies that was brought about to divide us was the lie of asymptomatic spread. So that was just brought in because all of the PCR test that has now been taken down because it never works and it doesn't work, and they've now, by the FDA, it's been withdrawn. So why has this whole thing not fallen over? That's right. That's right. And so we know that it's not about health. They said to us, I don't know, way back when last year, vaccinated 70-80%, get vaccinated. Then we'll give you your freedoms back. I say to everybody who is sitting at home, having gotten the two jabs, where are our freedoms?
Yes, exactly.
The government has lied to you, and the government continues to lie to you. This is not about health, this is about control. It is about taking our democratic rights away from us, and once governments expand to the degree that they have expanded through this pandemic, they never shrink and they never give rights back voluntarily. That is shown throughout history, throughout the world. So Australia, wake up or else it will all be gone. Thank you.
Coming in with heart conditions and all that coming up soon. He said it's about a 1 month wait after the jab, and then they start rolling in from whatever age group has just had it, okay? So I've had an 18-year-old girl standing on stage with me at one of the rallies in Melbourne. She's now got serious heart conditions. She blacks out, passes out, everything, and it was brought on from the vaccine. It's actually on the paperwork as a possible reason. So we are all here for a really good reason. Let's keep it about that. It's about the kids. We need to stop this from happening any further. Thank you, Sammy. Thank you, Sammy. All the good work she's doing, that's amazing. Save our children.
Save our children.
Who wants to hear the verdict?
Yeah!
Who wants to hear the verdict?
Yeah!
everybody. Can you hear me?
No.
Right next to your mouth like that. Hello, can everybody hear me?
Yes.
Okay, so my name's Suzanne Priddle. I am the director of the Youth Advocate, and we have had the application in the High Court for the injunction on the vaccines for the 0 to 19 children. We did our submissions before Christmas, and we asked for an urgent mention, and today they've handed down a judgment. I'm going to read it out for everybody because it's quite short and to the point, and they're basically letting us know exactly where the High Court stands.
As long as it's positive.
I'm just the messenger at this point.
Can everyone in the crowd be quiet? Nobody speak, and let's hear this because it's really hard. We don't have a good audio, so just everyone be quiet.
Please. I apologise about the audio, everyone. It was supposed to turn up and it didn't. Okay, so it says, the applicant has filed an application seeking expedition of the determination of the applicant's application and seeking leave to appeal from a decision that was handed down by Justice of the High Court of Australia, Keane J. Now, Justice Keane identified the application was frivolous and vexatious.
No surprises.
So we went back and we said there's nothing frivolous about 6.2 million children and there's nothing vexatious about just taking a step back and doing some clinical trials and making sure this is safe for our children. The High Court has gone on to say Justice Keane had refused the applicant's application for leave to issue a file for a constitutional or other writ, which is necessary by reason of the direction of Gagler. Justice Gagler is the person who started with the application and put down the direction of what avenues we needed to take to get this matter through the High Court. And he was very helpful and I will say, for want of a better, was able to do his job as expeditiously as possible. It is appropriate to consider both the application and the expedices and the application for leave together. There is no reason to doubt the correctness of the decision of Justice Keane. The application otherwise has no prospect of success and raises no question of principle.
Corruption at its best, of course.
Leave should be refused. Accordingly, it would be futile to grant the order for expedition. Pursuant to Rule 41.08.1 of the High Court Rules, we direct that the registrar to draw up, sign and seal an order dismissing this application.
What is wrong with you?
Triple facts, judges, and corrupt, complicit.
And
judges, guys. A little bit of quiet, please. I know we're all
independent.
A little bit of quiet, please. I know we're all angry and passionate, but let's just let this lady speak, and then we're going to deal with it, okay? So just let her finish.
So what we know is there is nothing insignificant about our children. If anybody is here of a different opinion, and we are here not for the children, then please feel free to stand up and tell me I'm wrong.
Let their kids take it first.
Quiet.
So, what we need to do is we need to recognise the High Court of Australia is not listening to our children.
That's right.
Yes.
It has no relevance or significance with anything to do with our children.
Yeah.
It's listening to the government.
Yeah.
It's being ruled by our current Prime Minister.
Freemasons!
And this decision was made, for the vaccines, was made by the Prime Minister himself. It didn't come from the TGA.
The TGA cannot authorise a vaccine that is not approved in Australia. The only one who can do that in Australia is the Prime Minister. We have avenues now that we will take on in order to ensure that the High Court of Australia is held for its judgment. We will not stand down and we will not be quiet. We will make sure the Prime Minister of Australia knows that our children are number one. They may not vote and they may not pay taxes, but you know what? They are the backbone of this country. And it is the future.
More taxes.
Come on, contract.
All right, guys. We all are pissed off, okay? So just let her finish speak, okay?
Shame on you!
All right, quiet!
Shame on you!
Shame on you! Shame on you! Shame on you! Shame on you! Shame on you! Shame on you! Shame on you! Shame on you! Shame on you! Shame on you! Shame on you! Shame on you! Shame on you! Shame on you! Shame on you! Shame on you! Shame on you! Shame on you! Shame on you! Shame on you! Shame on you! Shame on you! Shame on you!
Child against my wishes. You're going to stand for that?
Protecting it.
For a 99% survival rate. 99%.
99.99.
Repeater percent survival rate.
She's been injected from
it won't hurt you.